Welcome to Hard Copy. The Trade Union Congress of the Philippines is seeking a wage increase in Calabarzon, but the Labor Department admits this may not be possible by May 1. Watch this report.
The Labor Department has instructed the Regional Tripartite Wage and Productivity Board of the National Capital Region to fast-track public consultation on the wage hike petition amid calls from concerned groups in the midst of extraordinary increases in the price of basic commodities triggered by the series of oil price hikes. The Wage Board recently dismissed the 90 peso wage hike petition filed by the Trade Union Congress of the Philippines, saying there is no supervening condition to merit a salary increase. A review of current wage rates is underway, but DOLE notes a wage increase, if at all, will not be approved in time for May 1 Labor Day. A decision is expected after May 26. On Tuesday, the TUCP filed a petition for an additional 86 peso increase in minimum pay for workers in Cavite, Laguna, Batangas, Rizal, and Quezon provinces or Calabarzon. The Employers' Confederation of the Philippines is opposed to the wage hike, saying it would lead to job losses. Amid such challenges, Youth Group Anakbayan says about half of Batch 2012 is expected to end up jobless this year in the face of government's supposed lack of a coherent job generation plan. The ongoing repatriation of Filipinos from Syria and Yemen poses another dilemma for the labor sector. Over 1,000 OFWs have availed of mandatory repatriation since government implemented it in December amid the violence in Syria. The United Nations says the year-long Syrian conflict has killed more than 9,000 people.
And joining us on Hot Copy, Labor Secretary Rosalinda Baldoz. Good day to you, Secretary. Hindi ko alam kung good day ang bati ko sa iyo.
Always good day.
Always good day. All right, just to clarify, the TUCP filed an 86 peso increase for Calabarzon, Cavite, yes, etc. But
yes,
also
it's 4A, Region 4A.
But they also filed a 90 peso increase for NCR.
NCR.
Okay.
Yes.
All right. Tell us where you are now with this petition.
The Wage Board for NCR already considered the petition of TUCP of 90. First, they determine na wala yung superbening event,
okay,
the ever famous term.
What is supervening?
Supervening event.
Event, okay.
Meaning extraordinary increases in the prices of oil. That also affects the increases in the prices of commodities over a sustained period of time.
Okay.
And then the Wage Board said there is no such condition right now and would defer the hearing of the petition until May 26, which is the anniversary date of the last wage increase,
mm-hmm,
because that is what is required in the law.
Now, May 26 was last year's last wage increase.
Yes.
How much ang naging increase nun across the board?
22 pesos cost of living allowance.
22 pesos. So,
yes,
pag ganun kola yun?
No. Pag sinabing minimum wage, Karen, ang understanding, it's either the adjustment is in the basic pay,
uh-oh,
or cost of living allowance.
Basta iakyat nyo.
Oo, basta iakyat. So, it covers the two elements would be the minimum wage.
So, just for the record, right now in NCR, it is 426 pesos,
yes,
a day.
Minimum
wage, ang gusto po ng TUCP is plus 90.
90.
So it will be 516 pesos a day ang gusto nila.
Yes.
What happens if you increase it by 90 and up to 516? What is the effect?
Ganito muna, Karen, before I answer that, there are three items dun sa petition ng TUCP, bakit naging 90.
Okay.
First, meron silang gustong kinumpute. They say they actually computed a 1.24 increase dun sa prices ng commodities between June 2011, last up to February.
1 peso and 24 centavos?
1.24 percent increase, equivalent to 5 pesos and 28 centavos. Yun ang isang item. Yun ang ganun laki naman. Pangalawa,
true, huh?
Pangalawa, meron silang pinureject na 9% increase sa cost of consumer price index. Ito yung CPI. No? Ang kwenta niyan is 38 pesos and 34 centavos.
In a period of 1 year?
Yes, for the period of 1 year. Itong year na ito. Itong current year na ito.
Mm-hmm.
And then, they computed 46 pesos a share of the workers in the growth of the gross domestic product for the last 23 years, since 1989 up to the present.
Now, so are there figures accurate?
First, yung actual 1.24 increase na 528, yan ang aming tinatawag na, ano to, yung you restore the erosion in the purchasing power of the workers. And nung grant yung 22 pesos cola, taken into account itong increases for this year.
So, kumbaga, so, cover yun. Yun na ang sumagot. Uh-oh. Sa 5 pisong increase, yung increase na 22 pesos noon.
Oo, cover yun up to December. Etong kanilang petition, meron silang hinihingi na up to February 2012, yung kanilang computation ng 528. Pag kinumpute mo yan, at presently, mga 0.8% yun. So, kasi ito talagang, ano to eh, computation ito. Yes. No? Kaya pwede nating pag-usapan, ano. Tapos yung projected 9%, ang Bangko Sentral ang naglalabas on a monthly basis ng inflation rate. Mm-mm. Sa taong ito, mula January hanggang December, ang projection nila is 3% low and a high of 5%. So medyo...
So may, not 9%.
Oo, yung ganun. And then yung share of workers, para itong... I think they remember that the last minimum wage natin, national minimum wage, was in 1998, I think, which is 180 pesos. At nag-compute sila for the last 23 years, 2 pesos ang equivalent niyan per year. Yung ganon. But tayo na may halos taon-taon, nag-a-adjust tayo ng wage na even beyond the 2 pesos na kinukompute nila. So in other words, taken into account at hindi lang minimum wage ang paraan ng gobyerno to equitably distribute growth and wealth. Kasi other than minimum wage, meron tayong mga, like for example, tax exemption ng income, sa income. Mga ano yan, umaabot yan ng mga 45 pesos per capita. So, maraming kaparaan.
So, ito pong naka-minimum wage na 426 na nire-request na ng TUCP ng increase, tax exempt ito.
Tax exempt.
So, yung 426 dapat neto,
neto
sa
yan,
NCR.
Neto yan, yes.
So, yung ang punto po ng TUCP is because of the increase in commodity and fuel prices, yung kapangyarihan ng pera daw po nila has decreased to 42%. So yung 426 pesos nila is actually just worth 200 pesos a day.
Maring tama yun, kaya lang ang sistema ng wage increase ay kino-cover yung projected increase nga for the year. Mm-hmm. Say kung mag-i-increase tayo ngayon, i-cover yan nung up to December na projected 3 to 5% inflation rate. And then kung next year from January at magkaroon ulit tayo ng wage increase, then that will be covered by another projected inflation rate ng central bank. At the time na igagrant yung wage increase, pwede namang makompute actually kung magkano yung increase kasi projection yun eh. So naglalabas naman sila on a monthly basis.
All right. Now, if the request or the petition of the TUCP is given, how does it affect small and medium enterprises?
Napakalaki kasi sa dami ng establishment natin ng mga 800,000, no? Ang micro and small, which is from 1 to 9 ang employees lang, mga 770,000 yan.
Okay.
Ang natitira yung medium and big na above ano na yan, mga 6,000 lang yan. So sila yung may capacity to really pay whatever wage increases. At kahit sa minimum wage earner mo lang yan ibigay, Karen, the company will have to adjust the pay structure because magkakaroon ng wage distortion. Kaya lahat yon affected. Hindi ka pwedeng magkwenta on the part of the employer ng cost mo dun lang sa pinakamababa. Lahat yon i-adjust mo.
Now, sinusundan ba ito ng mga, let's say, big department stores? Kunyari, sales lady ang empleyado nila. Given na every 6 months, pumipirma ng contract yun, ha? Para hindi pa mapermanente yung mga sales lady, mga cashier. Does the DOLE monitor if they follow the 426 minimum?
they have to pay the minimum wage because that is really minimum, no?
Yeah.
There are wage order that would exempt certain establishment.
Like what?
Retail.
Sa really?
Retail. Sa retail. And they had to show na, ano na to, impaired yung kanilang capital up to a certain percent.
Can you give me an example? Like for example? There are some retail that's exempted from 426?
They have to file a petition for exemption.
Yeah.
It is not...
Yes.
Even if there are... exemption in the wage order, each individual establishment will have to go through the filing of the petition. And
can you give me an example that you know of that's paying below 426 and it was allowed?
Yung mga what do you call this? Distress company.
Distress
company. Impaired na yung kanilang capital.
Okay.
Say 75%.
So, yes.
Yon, tutulungan mo na yon na makabawi. No?
But I'm curious,
for a one-year period lang yung exemption mo.
Now, what happens to, like, Jollibee, McDonald's?
They pay the minimum wage.
That's minimum. That's or minimum higher? Wage. Or basta minimum?
Minimum wage. Because after minimum wage, Karen, the ideal situation is you determine already the adjusted wage increase based on your performance.
Okay.
Minimum wage is supposed to take care of the new entrants.
Okay.
Walang experience, walang skills.
Yeah.
So, talagang protection or safety net for those who are entering the labor force for the first time na wala silang mga kakayanan. Ang ideal is you increase the wage based on productivity and performance, meaning added skills na. Dito, ang ating ginagawa, ang measurement natin sa pag-adjust ng wage ay yung mga erosion ng purchasing power ng workers because of the adjustment in the prices.
Uh-oh.
Kaya mine-measure yan based dun sa inflation rate.
Uh-oh.
But over and above that, it should be based on productivity. Uh-oh. Already.
Yes. So technically, ang 426, it averages na around 9,000 a month.
Yes.
For a worker.
Yes.
Now, let's say carpintero, nagpapatayo ka ng bahay. Is that covered by 426?
Yes, all the workers are entitled to the minimum wage, no?
Uh-huh.
And of course the other added cost. Whatever be the benefits mandated by law, they get 13-month pay, they get holiday pay kung pinapapasok ka, kung at least yung 12 holiday pay, may service incentive leave. Well, employer has to make adjustments sa mga social security, sa mga PhilHealth. So, you are not just computing the wage increase that will be added either sa basic pay or sa COLA, but there are also added labor costs. So, ganun ang implication yan.
Now, what do you believe is possible? Clearly, it seems that the government is not open to a full 90 pesos. Is it even possible to have an increase?
I think our workers would expect an increase every year.
Okay.
Because, as I said, even the central bank would always, at the start of the year, project inflation rate. Ano yan? Kumbaga, very realistic na projection because there could be talagang adjustment in the prices of basic commodities.
Uh-oh.
And as I said, for this year, that is 3% to 5%.
Yeah.
And the board would always consider that.
Yeah.
When they start hearing the petitions after May 26, by the way, I instructed them to already start the informal consultation para ma-shorten naman yung formal public hearing after May 26, and hopefully they could grant immediately whatever they will determine by way of amount and even ano yung form.
Kung 22 pesos ang naging increase last year,
yes.
What are you seeing? Ano yung range of the possible increase to be given this year?
If you just use the inflation rate of 3 to 5%, that could be computed low of 13 pesos,
wow.
And maybe a high of, I think, 21. You know, just the projected. But every month, Karen, naglalabas ang central bank nung actual inflation rate.
Yeah.
Kaya yung 3%, and they ranged up to 5%. Ngayong February, ang kanilang projection lang is 2.3% for NCR.
Yeah.
So, yung sinasabi natin, yun yung range, from a range of, say, 13 to a high of 21. But as of February, ni hindi pumasok sa minimum range of 3% ang inflation rate ng NCR. 2.3% lang.
So, in a way, with this discussion, we are saying that above 21 pesos increase this year is technically not possible. Honestly.
Using the projected
So TUCP should get ready to move between the 13 to 21 range.
There is such a thing as kasi talagang negotiation
Cavite,
talaga.
Cavite, Calabarzon, iba pa yun.
Oo, magkakaiba. Yeah. Pagka sila like for example, diyan sa sinasabi mong Region 4A, talagang meron silang range din dyan, no? As high as this and as low as that, other than taking into account inflation, yung impact sa possible job losses o sa mga investment na pumapasok, and then gaano karami talaga yung maaapektuhan na micro and small enterprises within the region.
Okay. Now, on another take now, of course, other than the request for higher wages, is the fact that there aren't a lot of jobs to go by. And the government has been criticized for not spending enough when it comes to infrastructure projects to actually spur a worker, to actually spur jobs.
Job generation,
where you can pay more minimum wage and you can have work more all the time. China, they said, spends 5 to 8% of their GDP. We spend, I think, what do we spend? Is it 1.5 or 2?
For a job. Actually, it's really a function of investment, but government takes over, no?
Yeah,
the infrastructure budget has been big, except that last year, nagkaroon nga ng mga, you have to address all the leakages in the system. But starting the last quarter last year, di ba, nakita na natin na construction is now starting and
that's what President Aquino said. We have to see. He said he's hoping for 8 PPPs now to fly this year.
Last year, despite the so-called underspending, we created 1.156 million jobs.
Oh, really? Nationwide.
Beyond the national target of just 1 million on the average. Up to 2016, that's under the Philippine Development Plan.
And were the jobs long-term? What were they?
Although karamihan talaga dito would be still, ang number one would be in the service sector.
Yes.
Second would be in the agri and third, industry.
Yeah.
Industry.
Uh-oh.
So you will have an idea kung ano. Of course, services would include BPO, ICT, would include construction.
Uh-oh.
Yan ang sa services. When you talk of agri, so dyan talaga ang medyo yung quality talaga ay hindi ganun kataas compared sa services at compared din sa industry. Industry apparently nag-suffer naman dahil hindi pa nakakabango ng economy ng mga kumukuha ng ating mga produkto for export, but nag-pick up na siya nitong January. So we could expect na magtuloy-tuloy sana itong trend na yung industry, which is really, yun ang talagang quality jobs.
How many people don't have jobs? I mean, based on the records?
2.9 million.
Have registered, they don't have jobs, nationwide.
That's the result of the labor force survey quarterly being conducted by the NSO.
Yeah. Okay. All right. When we return, we'll take a quick break for now. Our guest, Labor Secretary Baldoz, will answer questions from you, our viewers, from Facebook and Twitter. Hot Copy will be right back.